It's Brian Preston, the money guy.
This one is from Aaron, and it says, and this is what Aaron asked, for someone under 40, if you can't save enough to max your IRA 1 year, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm assuming he's talking about his Roth IRA. Would you suggest selling off assets in a taxable account to move to a Roth IRA? So it sounds like this person has been building their buckets, right? And so they've got their tax-deferred bucket in the 401k, and they've got their after-tax bucket, and they got the Roth. But maybe something happened this year where cash flow was tight, and they just didn't have the $6,000 for a single person or the $12,000 for a couple to max out their Roths. The question he's asking is it okay or should I take money out of one bucket to get it into another bucket? Does that make sense?
I think this is a great question, but it also pays a lot of respect to the financial order of operations, which, by the way, go to moneyguy.com/resources to download your free copy of the 9 steps. You can go even deeper with the course, which we have special pricing on right now. But here's what I love about this is that I have been there. I've walked in their shoes, and the fact that there have been years that I didn't fully fund my Roth. And I'll be honest, there's been some regrets. You know, some of the content that's coming up that I've written about, I've actually, in a nerdy way, gone and figured out what those Roth IRA dollars that I should have invested would be worth right now. I went to go, I mean, maybe you're not supposed to go linger on past mistakes, but I wanted to go see what was the opportunity, cost of every dollar that I didn't get into that tax-free bucket. And it's big. Mm-hmm. I will tell you there, you do not underestimate the power of your army of dollar bills and that compounding tax-free growth that goes into Roth accounts. So you need to get very excited that the fact that the government knows that these benefits are so powerful, they limit your ability to fund. You can only do $6,000 a year. If you're under 50, you can do $7,000 if you're 50 and over. And then it's the same thing with your 401ks or 403bs that are Roth. They limit you to $19,500 on those things. They even limit your income. But here's the crux of the matter. If you have respected the FOO, and you have your deductibles covered, you have emergency reserves so that the bad stuff doesn't get you. You don't, you know, have a car accident or the hot water heater goes out and all these things, and it's not going to derail your financial life. As long as you're not getting into those pots of money, I do think it's okay to sell some of your after-tax investments, assuming they're not like 75% appreciated, sure, or 100% appreciated, assuming that the tax consequences don't crush you getting access to that money. Because you notice, Roth is step number 5. Maxing out retirement is step number 6. That comes before step 7, which is hyperaccumulation, which is where the additional after-tax buckets and some other things come into place. Do not underestimate that benefit of tax-free growth.
The other, you know, one of the biggest things that I hear people kind of fight this idea is, oh, you know, guys, I love it. I really want to do the Roth, but you know, that after-tax money, I might need that. I might need that for a vacation in a few years, or a down payment, or an engagement ring, or a, you know, fill in the blank, and all the things that you might potentially want to use that for in the future. If I put it into my Roth, I can't touch it till I'm 59 and a half. You know, that's got to be like retirement money. And that is absolutely true. You should have Roth assets sit there until 59 and a half. But if you're in that situation where you say, man, I just don't want to have that opportunity because I don't want to miss out on getting that in, one of the dirty little secrets of Roth that you should never, ever, 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 ever utilize, but is a true fact about the account, is you can always get to the money that you put in tax-free and penalty-free. You can always get your basis back out of your Roth if you had to. So if you're looking at it and you have this after-tax account and you have this Roth account and you're worried about captivating those dollars just in case, know that there's a fail-safe there. So in my opinion, if you have the ability to get it from the after-tax into the Roth, I think you should, because you only get so many opportunities, so many options to get money into that Roth bucket.
Yeah. Well, when you give that break glass approach where, you know, we're going to put the money in so you can have access, but you're hoping that you never have to actually need the money so you can let it work tax-free. My goal would be, if you do this, fast forward 2 years, you never had to actually use that money.
Right.
You didn't have the emergency that caused it. So that money actually got to do what it was supposed to and be part of your army of dollar bills, tax-free dollar bills.